Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm really excited because I'm gonna be doing my favorites and fails. I have a lot of products that I'm loving. I'm wearing most of them on my face right now, so we can talk about that. Tons of new releases are coming out. There's some stuff that I'm really liking that's a little bit too new, and then some stuff that I just can't stop using and I already know it's a favorite. So we're gonna talk all about that, as well as a couple products that I'm just not wowed by and I wouldn't recommend. I will save that towards the end of the video. Before we get into my favorites, I am partnering with Built Bar. For those of you that have been watching, you already know how much I love this. For new viewers, Built Bar is the best tasting protein bars on the market. I am so in love with these. You guys are so in love with them. I love hearing your feedback. But essentially, they are chocolate covered protein bars. They have an array of flavors, and they also do limited releases, which could be cookie dough chunk, coconut brownie chunk, white chocolate with sprinkles. So definitely follow them for more information. But what I love about these, first of all, is they taste incredible. Second of all, they're low calorie, high protein, low sugar. So for me, they're a healthy treat that makes me feel like I'm cheating, but I can stay on track. I have struggled with the sweet tooth, as you guys know. I have struggled with my weight as well, eating a lot of sugar and sweets, and this helps me curb that craving without having that guilt. So I have salted caramel here with me. That's what I'm gonna have today. To give you an idea, these are 130 calories, 17 grams of protein, 4 grams of sugar. So they're really low calorie, high protein. So if you're trying to get more protein in, this is a great option. Or if you just have a sweet tooth and you want something you can throw in your bag or have at night before bed to kind of curb your sweet tooth, these are great because they're just guilt-free. I do have a code, BabsBeauty10, will get you 10% off site-wide. So I will link them down below. I highly recommend these if you have a sweet tooth or you're just trying to get more protein in without the calories. So thank you again to Built Bar for sponsoring this portion of the video, and let's get into other favorites and fails. Had to start off with a bang, but I really am impressed with this palette, and I'm wearing it on my eyes again. I've been wearing it every single day, and I've just been enjoying playing with it. This is the new release from Patrick Ta. This is called the Multi-Dimension Eyeshadow Palette. Major Dimension Eyeshadow Palette. So I did a review on this, I can link down below. You have two cream shadows in here, which is really what makes this palette special. These creams are beautiful. They're not like the ones we've seen in the past in a couple Huda Beauty palettes that were kind of duds. These are actually creamy, but yet they set really beautifully under other shadows. So they really do work beautifully on the eye. I really want to play around with maybe like smudging these as liner. I haven't gotten there yet, but I have used them on my eyes multiple times as like a base. And then you have standard metallics in here, which are just high shine, gorgeous. You have the beautiful mattes, which blend incredibly. And then I think what really makes this palette special is the toppers as well. So there's a lot of different textures in here, but it's very unique in terms of the different textures, not necessarily the tones, because the tones are, again, very neutral. Now, it's not orangey warm, but it is a warm palette. Some people were asking me that. When I compare this to like the Natasha Denona bronze palette, the Natasha one is much warmer, like orangey, bronzy copper. This one is more of like a neutral leaning warm. So you have a little bit of like a maroon undertone in some of these browns. You have a little bit of, again, like that pinky bronzy color to it. It's just beautiful. There's so many different textures in here. The mattes blend incredibly. I love them. The creams are so special. The toppers, I would say, are like sophisticated glitter. That's the way I see them. I have it on right now. You don't need a glitter glue. You don't need to wet it. You just pack it on with your finger and it just stays all day. Very minimal fallout on every single shade. Very minimal. It's just, I don't know, something about this is stunning. I am impressed. Of course, we've seen these colors before. I know this, but for every day, this is what I'm wearing. And I usually am a matte type of girl, but the toppers in here make me want to put them on my eyes every single day, as I have on right now. I know it's a higher price tag, but I think the different textures is really what you're paying for, and the formulas are just really beautiful. So I highly recommend it if you are checking it out. It's beautiful. This next favorite is actually a tinted moisturizer, which I'm really shocked to say that I am enjoying quite a few tinted moisturizers recently, especially for every day, not necessarily for filming, but sometimes I do mix them in with a matte foundation to give me kind of the best of both worlds. So this was sent to me and I really thought it's not gonna give me any coverage because I have tried some tinted moisturizers that seem to just smear on top of my redness and I feel like I just end up looking blotchy and I don't like that. Now I do enjoy the Fenty Beauty Ease Drop, but I think I like this one even more. This is from NARS and it's called the Pure Radiant Tinted Moisturizer Broad Spectrum SPF 30 Sunscreen. I am shocked how much I love this. Now I have the shade Light 2 Alaska. This is what they sent me. I love this so much that I want to get a deeper shade. What I love about this is it's really glowy and natural, but it's very thin in texture. It's not heavy or gunky. I feel like a lot of times with CC creams or tinted moisturizers, there's either not enough coverage or they're really heavy, almost like they have skincare in them. And I feel like they just get really gunky around my pore areas and my chin. This does not do that. It's very dewy, but it's thin in texture. So it's quite flattering on texture, flattering on pores, flattering on acne. It doesn't like grab and give you those dry patches. It doesn't separate or slip off. Now it's definitely not gonna be a 12-hour wear. It's gonna be like 5 or 6 hours I have to blot and then it'll get me through until 8 or 9 hours. So it's an everyday type of product. I would say the coverage is a light medium. You can build it to a medium. Very similar to the Fenty Beauty Ease Drop in terms of coverage, but something about this, I just like the texture of it more. It's beautifully glowy, but it also is very smoothing on the skin. And that's not something I really see. This is just something that shocked me because I really didn't think that I was gonna enjoy it. But something about the way this sits on the skin and the coverage is just right for me. So if you're looking for a tinted moisturizer that actually has some coverage, this is a great option. Also the Fenty Beauty or the Wet n Wild. But I would say out of the three, this is my top pick. Speaking of NARS, they have a new product they sent in PR, and I haven't shown this on my channel yet, but I do have a video that I filmed with the tinted moisturizer and this new product, so if it's up, I'll link it. If it's not up, it's coming soon. This is brand new. It's called the Radiant Creamy Color Corrector. So they have 4 different shades in here, and it's in the same packaging as their Radiant Creamy Concealer, but it has this white kind of casing around it. I think this is such a great product. I had high hopes for it, and as I've mentioned before, I've been using my Pixi Corrector or the Becca Corrector, even the Charlotte Tilbury, because I felt like I was caking on concealer and it wasn't covering the blueness under my eyes. So I was really excited when I got this in PR. They have 4 different shades, and the one thing I will say is they do run darker than the Becca. So the light shade is actually a little bit deeper than probably what you're used to. It has a brush tip, like a brush tip for a lip gloss, but it's almost like cut in half, so it's very short. I love that. You can get right up in here and apply this. It's creamy, just like the Radiant Creamy Concealer. It has a lot of coverage to the point where I can put it over blemishes, which I did in that video I filmed. Again, if it's up, I'll link it. If not, it's coming. But I put it under my eyes to color correct the blueness. And then I had some breakout scars or redness from just like healing acne. And I would just dab it on there and it actually covered. So it's almost like a 2-in-1 for me because it's a corrector, but it's also like a spot concealing product for me. So here's the shade Light. It's definitely got that peachy tone to it. Not pinky really, it's like more peachy. But I'm telling you, I love the formula. It just blends out beautifully. It doesn't grab on, it doesn't enhance my texture. So I've been really impressed with this, using it as a spot conceal, also using it right under my eyes where I have that blueness. I feel like it's quite smoothing, a little bit hydrating, and I just really like it. It's brand new. I really haven't even talked about it much, but I've used it every single day since I got it in PR. Next, I want to talk about a brow product that I can't stop using, and I was scrolling the Sephora app the other day, as I do every single day, and I saw that this was on Sephora, and I was like, oh my gosh, I was so excited. I sent a text to my friend Cheryl, like, check it out, because she's been wanting it, but shipping from the actual website is like duties, and the shipping's expensive, so I am so thrilled that this is on Sephora now, and this is the Refi Beauty Brow Cream. This brand is owned by Jess Hunt on Instagram, who's like absolutely stunning, and she has these huge bushy eyebrows. They're just literally like, when you think of the bushy brow trend, she is the model for that. And she came out with this brand, Refi. So she came out with brow products. She first came out with a pomade, a brow pencil, and then this brow cream. Now you can get the whole set, which I bought when I bought it from the website, or you can get them separately. This is the standout product for me. So when you open it, you have a kind of long spoolie, it's very thin, and you just brush this into your brows to really get them to have that fluffy appearance. And then it's interesting, you close this and then you take the cap off. It's sort of hidden, and you have a double-sided kind of brow grooming brush, so you can brush them up again, separate them with this side, and then you can really just push your brow hairs against your face and they set all day. If you go to the Refi Beauty page, everybody raves about this. This is such a phenomenal product. I mean, she's the queen of brows, so I really expected nothing less. But the fact that you can get this on Sephora now and not have to wait for shipping, I highly, highly, highly recommend this. And I also really love the brow pencil as well. The pomade is just a little bit heavy for me because I need something really precise to do the brow-like strokes. If you have very thick brows, you might like the pomade, but I would say my recommendation is 100% this and then the brow pencil. It's very fine. It's like a little bit bigger than the Huda Beauty one, but a little bit smaller than the Benefit precisely. It's kind of like right in between. Just beautiful products. And she actually did just release a new collection of cream blushes and a liquid highlighter and a cream bronzer. And I purchased it from her website, but I'm wondering if it's going to be coming to Sephora. So if you've been wanting to try Refi Beauty, the brow products, they're on Sephora now. I will link them down below, but this is such a phenomenal brow product. Next, I have to give a shout out to a bronzer that I cannot stop using, and I purchased this when I did a sponsorship with YSL Beauty. I really wanted to do like a full face of YSL, and I had never tried this, and I have to say, I love this. So this is the YSL Beauty bronzer. I have the shade 02 here. It's called like the Bronzing Stones. This shade is so beautiful, and it has that baked gelé texture, which I tend to really like because there's no powder kickup, it doesn't cling, and it's buildable. This is such a beautiful bronzer, and I've had quite a few of you comment like, what bronzer are you wearing? And it's literally been this one. It has a little bit of a radiance to it, but I love the tone of it. This is not a red tone, this shade in particular. It's more of like a, I would say like an olive orangey tone, very warm, so it gives you that nice warmth, but it's very smoothing on your texture. It doesn't cling. As I said, I don't feel that it gets muddy. It is really just a beautiful bronzer. I cannot stop using it. This one and the Physician's Formula are like my top picks right now. I look healthy, like I've gotten some sun, even though I haven't. And I really just can't say enough good things about this. I just keep reaching for it and reaching for it and reaching for it because it just blends beautifully. I don't have any skipping or grabbing, and I just love the radiance that it gives me while also making my skin look really smooth. Next up, I have a fairly new blush formula that I just can't get enough of. I'm wearing it right now, and I have a specific color that's really wowing me. This is from Say Beauty, and this is called the Dew Blush. The shade I have on right now, Peachy, is so freaking gorgeous. I really just cannot get over it. I feel like this is such a sophisticated peachy color because there's really no pink to it. It has almost that creamsicle orange peach to it. It is so gorgeous, and these blend so effortlessly. So I just take the doe foot and put it on the back of my hand, as I do with any cream blush, use a sponge and tap it over powder. These work over powder. You can see I look pretty dewy. You really don't even need a highlight with these. And then I also have the shade Rosy. Rosy is another one I love if you want a little bit more of that pink to it. So Rosy is right here, Peachy right here. Peachy's my favorite though. I don't know what it is. I feel like Peachy goes really good with like full glam, whereas the other ones go better with like natural makeup, like that flushed look. Peachy is just like sophisticated gorgeousness. I don't know what else to say. And then I've yet to use Poppy, but I really want to. This one is really intense. It's more of that like orange kind of coral. So I do want to use Poppy, but I've been using Peachy and Rosy just all the time. I bought these all myself. They are just that beautiful. And the fact that they go beautifully over your powder, they give me a glow. And when I feel my face, it's a little bit tacky, but it's not uncomfortable. And I feel feel like it kind of livens up my face because I am quite matte in the center. So if you're looking for a blush that's gonna give you a little bit of dew to your face, but it's not gonna be like heavy tacky or making your texture look bad, or lifting your powders, I highly recommend these, and the colors are stunning. Just make sure that you're putting them on with a sponge like I do. I just never do dot it on my face and blend, because for me, that's just like going to lift every single time, no matter the formula. So I like to do the back of my hand and then really lightly press them on, and that way it doesn't disrupt my powder and I can put them on last and get the glow and the color I'm looking for. But I've just been so impressed with these. I love them so much, I highly recommend. I also couldn't do this video without raving about the new tinted Forget the Filler glosses from Lawless. I am such a fan of the Lawless Forget the Filler original gloss. I went through an entire one and then I bought another one from Sephora. And then I saw that she came out with two different colors. So we have Velvet, which is more of like a mid-tone pinky color. And then we have Daisy Pink, which is like that baby doll color. I'm honestly so impressed with the feel, the smell, the color, the look of these glosses. They are stunning and they are so high shine. If you like that really reflective high shine gloss, these are gonna be for you. They really do sort of just make your lips look plump and juicy. They feel incredible. They like coat the lips and then they like hang on. They're not ones that are slipping and sliding. They're a thicker formula, but they're not like a MAC lip gloss where it's like super tacky. They're sort of in between, but the colors are beautiful. I really think she should take this and run with it and come out with a bunch of different colors. I really don't know what else to say about these other than if you want high shine, really comfortable, beautiful colors, I think you would really enjoy these. These are just one of my favorite lip gloss formulas as of right now, and I just can't get enough of them. I want her to come out with like 20 shades. Next up, I have to take a moment and seriously rave about these brushes, and I would not do this if I really wasn't wowed. I had seen so many YouTubers raving about these brushes for so long, and I went ahead and placed an order. I think I bought like 5 or 6 brushes. They must have seen my order and sent me the rest of their brushes, which I was like, oh my God, I did not expect that. So huge thank you to BK Beauty. But regardless of that, let me tell you about these brushes. So these are the BK Beauty brushes, and I have to say, people rave about them for a reason. These are absolutely incredible brushes. I have not used the eye brushes from them yet, but I've used some of the face brushes, and I'm gonna tell you the standouts to me. First of all, everybody raves about this, but there's a reason. This is the BK Beauty 101. So it's a slanted foundation brush, quite large, and there's something so special about this and the way that it blends. You can really stipple for more coverage, or you can swipe, you can buff. This is just such a perfect foundation brush. I found myself really wanting to reach for this over like all of my brushes. I look at this and I'm like, I want to use you every single day. I feel like this would be a great one also for like cream products, cream contour, blush, stuff like that. So I really have to give it to them. This is an amazing quality brush. I really am that impressed. Also for foundation, I'm really loving this brush. This is the 106. So this one I like for more of a kind of airbrushed look. This one is a little bit fluffier. Again, you could use this for any cream products, but I like this one to really sort of go back and forth with, whereas this one I feel like is nice to like press in. This one is almost like that Makeup by Mario foundation brush if you got that set from Sephora, and it's really nice to just sort of like blend back and forth and give you that airbrushed light coverage. So I've really been enjoying this too. I'm serious when I tell you I am really, really impressed. When I got these, I really didn't know what to expect. I figured I would really like this one because this is different from anything in my collection, but I am freaking impressed with these. And then I've been loving this brush. This is the 108. So typically I use a sponge and I bake down the center of my face. But lately, again, I've been using less concealer, less powder, trying to do more of like a natural look. So instead of using a sponge and baking, I've just been using this in a pressed powder or a loose powder and just kind of going down my T-zone like this. So I'm using less powder. I'm not looking as dry or cakey. So I'm gonna actually touch up. I'm gonna take my No. 7 powder. I've been enjoying this. And I'm just going to use this. This is such a perfect size and fluffiness, denseness. I mean, honestly, these brushes are freaking incredible. I understand the hype. They just are really high quality and they just work beautifully. I feel like you could use this again for a highlight. Really, you could use this for so many things, but I just really am enjoying these brushes. So these are standouts for me. I still have to use all the eye brushes, and I mean, I feel like I've only tried like 5 of the brushes so far, but these 3 just really wowed me, and I just really need them top drawer every time I do my makeup. And my last favorite before we get into a couple fails, I am so in love with this fragrance, and it is probably the most affordable fragrance in my collection. This is $19. This is from Mix Bar, and it's called Vanilla Bourbon. This is from Target. So they have this Mix Bar collection that has like coconut and vanilla, I think rose. They have a bunch of different scents. They're very affordable. They have pens that have oil of the fragrance in them, and then they have the actual bottles here. So this is 1.7 ounces, and it's $18.99, and you can get it at Target. When I tell you this smells freaking intoxicating, I am not joking. This is heaven in a bottle. This is what I wanted Killian Angel Share to be. Killian Angel Share was supposed to be like cognac and vanilla, but I really smelled heavy on the booze and like a cinnamon twist to it. This is vanilla bourbon, and I feel like it is so sweet and musky vanilla, but you do get that bourbon backing where it's like you get a hint of bourbon, but it's not like you just poured Jack Daniels or whatever all over you. You know, cognac, you know what? I haven't drank in quite a while, and if I do drink, I'm going for like Ciroc. So I don't know the difference between all the whiskeys and the cognacs and all that. You get that little bit of spice of like the bourbon backing, but it really is just like a sweet vanilla cozy, like vanilla, caramel, bourbon. I really don't know what else to say other than bathe me in this. I cannot get enough of this. It is so delicious. And the word that I want to use is intoxicating. I just can't say enough good things about it. You can see I keep using it. I use this pretty much every single day just around my house, and I just keep smelling it, and it's just like so delicious to me. So this is a hit, super affordable, accessible at Target. I will link it down below. And to finish off this video, I do have a couple fails. They may work for you, but for me, I just really wasn't impressed. The first one is the Artist Couture Ethereal Bloom Eyeshadow Palette. So I bought this. I thought this packaging was so adorable. I think I got this during the sale or maybe right before. Time, literally, I have zero concept of like what day it is. I don't know about you, but I'm like, what month is it? I don't even know what year it is. Who knows? But I bought this, and I really thought that it was gonna be like this beautiful summer palette that I could throw like this orangey shade in my crease, or even just this neutral shade, or the purple, or this nude shade, and then maybe a little bit of like an iridescent on the lid. But I have to say that these mattes just really kind of blend away. I feel like I had to put like 5 layers on to get any pigment in the crease. And then the toppers or the shimmers are really chunky, and they sort of like grab and get like chunky in certain areas, and then they don't grab in others. They're not smooth. They're very like uneven, and they don't want to stick down. They're just not pigmented enough. And when I got this, I thought this is going to be sort of like the Huda Beauty Mercury Retrograde palette that is very pastel, but it's pigmented. And I feel like there's a lot of different textures. There's toppers, but also metallics, but their mattes really do show up. And these, I feel like I just had to work too hard for it, and I really don't want to do that. I don't want to like have to use a glitter glue and really pack stuff on, or I don't want to have to smooth out, you know, chunky texture toppers on my lid, or use a white base to get the purple to show up. For me, it was just not worth the hassle. I love the packaging. I think it's adorable, but this just really was one of those eyeshadow formulas that I really was like, this is too much work for what it is, and I won't reach for it again. And my last fail, I want to get your guys' feedback on, because I want to see if you've used this and maybe just the shade's throwing me off, or if there's like a different way to use this product. So as I said, I've been into the tinted moisturizers, and I've really been wanting to try them for every day. So I picked up this Revlon Photo Ready Candid Glow. This is called the Moisture Glow Anti-Pollution Foundation. So it's actually called a foundation, but I thought, okay, it's glowy, it's going to be less coverage. So I picked up the shade 270 Medium Beige. And it is so incredibly like gray. I don't know what is going on here, because it's really, really cool tone, but almost in a gray undertone. It's not like pinky. It did not give me any coverage, and I just felt like I looked ill. And I don't know if it's just the color of this, like maybe I need to get like warm beige, but has anybody tried this? I haven't really seen anybody talk about this, to be honest, in the beauty space, but I just felt like it kind of was smearing around, and then I just looked sick, like almost ashy sick, and I don't know if it was just the color, and because I really didn't like the way it was sitting on my skin, I didn't get a different shade, but I want to get your feedback. And I like the idea of like a glowy everyday tinted moisturizer, so I picked this up. I think I was at Target one day. So for me, this was a dud. I just would much rather use the Fenty or the NARS or even the Wet n Wild. All right, guys, so that's everything for my current favorites and a couple fails. I really didn't have many fails, but those were two that stood out to me that I just was really not impressed with and I wouldn't tell you to go buy. I am loving the Jaclyn Cosmetics blushes, but they are so new to me and there's so many different formulas that I'm continuing to play around with them. But I'm loving all of the formulas. There's nothing that's like a dud to me, but I feel like I really want to test out all the colors before I go in and say like this is a favorite because I'm really enjoying all of them. So that's a little update on the Jaclyn Cosmetics. I'm continuing to use them. I will link everything that I talked about today down below. Don't forget to check out Built Bars if you haven't already. They are delicious. Thank you guys again so much for watching. I hope you'll subscribe if you're new, and I'll see you in the next video.